Hey everybody, it's Noah. I'm your Monday mentor. Just wanted to send you some quick strategies regarding the whole idea of social media. Are you watching it boil? And this is a technique that I use on my own life for productivity that has radically changed everything in terms of me getting things done. And I hope this really helps you. I find and have noticed in my past that I've been sitting there literally checking it hundreds of times a day. It would go from checking Instagram hundreds of times over to Facebook hundreds of times to Twitter and Periscope, everything, just trying to constantly measure. And what I found that what that did was it robbed time for how I was actually getting my life and getting my life done. But I was finding my identity in it, and that was the tough thing. Anything from having to do with likes or comments or feedback, it just became the barometer for how the day was going, and it consumed everything. So years ago, and actually really strong probably over the last 12 months, I implemented a discipline that radically changed things for me. And that went from checking throughout the entire day as I put parameters on when I actually checked in. And so I gave that my goal, learn it through the 4-hour work week, which is a great technique, and a few other mentors in my life, of checking it primarily at noon and checking it also in the end of the day. And the reason why I did that was having specific times that I checked allowed me to really put things off as it pertained to actually where I made money. As an entrepreneur and as a business person, I had to look at the fact that if I'm checking social media and doing comments and things like that right now, is this actually going to translate to an earned dollar? And one of the things that I train through Noah University and teach folks is how to make money online. Well, you don't make money online if you're just sitting on social media. You make money online if you're producing products and content and actually getting them up online, and then you can go and talk about them. But how often do I need to talk about them? I need to talk about them twice a day at the most. So I'm usually checking in at lunchtime, and then I'm checking again towards the end of the day around 4 or 5 o'clock, considering the time differences around the world, primarily New York. So anybody that's on the East Coast, 3 hours ahead, that's about 8 o'clock their time, 5 o'clock my time if I check in at 5 p.m. Why do I do this? I do this because once I check in the afternoon, I have to wait till the entire next day in order to get back onto my social media. But primarily, this is for my email. This first step is social media, but the biggest step is your email. And what I found is whenever I checked my email at noon, I would maybe have random things that were sales emails, but for the most part, I only had a couple that actually needed to be responded to. Then when I checked back in at 4, I had even less, maybe one or two emails that actually came in that needed to be responded to. And this goes for working at a place of business, whether you're working at a cubicle, you're working at a corporate America job, or you're an entrepreneur. But if you want to give yourself a raise, and if you want to see yourself get more productive and produce more in 1 week, I can tell you right now my productivity went up by 80% because I was not living online. And that goes for social media, that goes for notifications, and that goes for checking email. I can just tell you right now, it's one of the toughest disciplines that you'll ever do. But the only time that I am responding to anything is from my team that needs something urgently on a text message. So I went into my phone, took off any notification that I had on my phone. I don't get an alert for anything except a text message. And primarily, those are my favorites, and those are my team members. And when I have my team on board, those are the only ones that I check when I do look at texts. But this allows me to wake up. My normal routine is I wake up, I do my quiet time, I do my working out. I'm able to be present at breakfast with my kids. We have our Bible time with our kids, prayer time, get them to school. I'm not driving looking at my phone. I'm present, I'm listening to music, I'm doing a lot more praying, and I'm not distracted. I then go into production, and when I'm in production, I'm literally not having my day ran by my email, and I'm not having it done by my social media. I'm the boss, I'm the one in charge of my time, I'm the one that's going to have to account for it at the end of the week. And I just do want to tell you this. You are spending, and I was a victim of spending so much time online that literally it ruled my day. and I was losing hours, meaning if my whole entire goal is to work the entire day to then go and spend time off with my family, I'm literally robbing my family time by all the online time I'm spending throughout the day. So if I'm going into work mode and production mode, working on my pieces, working on my sketches, working on my blog, working on this video, working on building my brand will not be built while I'm sitting there checking social media and checking email. That literally can wait. I'm not saying not to check it at all. I'm saying just to wait and be strategic and plan that time. Here's the good news. The more folks, even if you put an autoresponder on your actual email, the more folks that know this about you, they will not even send you them and expect a response from you until your lunch hour and also until the end of the day. This is one of the best disciplines that I could teach my kids and anybody that I run life with, because if you want to be a leader and you want to be an entrepreneur, this requires being strategic and disciplined with your time. How do you get more time back? When you're not wasting it. How do you not waste it? Is when you're burning it on things that don't produce value and income. Does a comment matter? Does it matter to talk to your community? Does it matter to talk to your tribe? Absolutely, but it doesn't need to be instantaneous on the response. Lastly, I'll tell you this. When it comes to responding to your tribe, scarcity sometimes is greater. The fact that you literally can reply to an email all the time is the worst sign that it comes across needy, almost desperate, that you can be reached so easily. The fact that you respond to emails so quick, the fact that you respond to text messages so quick. Listen, everybody else is running your life. You're not running it. So how can you get back into the driver's seat? Pause on your responses, get rid of your notifications, and take your email and social media and check in on them twice a day. And when I check, that doesn't mean I sit there and write emails for the next hour, hour and a half. I want to produce and work on those things that provide me value and get the job done. The moment I am finished, and my emails usually take, listen to this, emails usually take me under 60 seconds to check and respond to on my lunch hour, literally a minute. After that, I go back to doing what I need to do, spending time with the person that's in front of me, and I'm working on this daily. Now, just to let you know, I'm working at this constantly to get better at it, because there are the days I fall off the wagon and all of a sudden my thumb defaults right to just opening up email when I shouldn't be, and literally starts going just as a default. So fight for it. It's worth it. Your time is worth it. Your family is worth it, because ultimately that's what you want. Everybody's crying for more time. I'm telling you, this is how you get more time. I hope that helps. Please leave a comment below and forward this to somebody you know who needs it. Talk to you soon. See ya.